Trump is as destructive a person in this century as Hitler, Stalin, and Mao were in the last century. He may be responsible for many more million deaths than they were.
With Don Lemon getting sued and Fredo Cuomo losing his mind for the world to see, it appears that their low ratings are finally taking their toll. I mean, did this guy seriously just compare Donald Trump to the world's worst communist dictators? This guy, who appears to be either falling asleep or really drunk, provides zero evidence to back up his insane claim, and to make it worse, Brian Stelter just sits there and doesn't challenge any of it. We'll get right back to this media meltdown, but first let me just take a quick moment to thank this video's sponsor, RibTee.com. Guys, I know that we all need to constantly replace our t-shirts and underwear because we buy them cheap, in bulk, and at department stores. I'm here today to implore you to consider stepping up to a higher quality, immensely more comfortable choice. Not only are they American made, but RibTee is a company that values free speech and YouTubers like yours truly. If you need new t-shirts and underwear, and I think we all know that you do, treat yourself and try something that will not only feel amazing and improve your mood, but will also outlast anything that you bought from a department store. Head on over to ribtee.com/dronetech and make sure that you use the promo code DRONETECH to get 20% off most items. If you would like me to give your channel or your website a shout out, simply make a purchase at ribtee.com/dronetech and send me the proof of purchase. Thank you. Has anyone else noticed the shocking rise in batshit lunacy from the Democrat media ever since the Russian collusion hoax died? The New York Times even admitted that after the Russian collusion hoax has died, they need something else to bash Trump over the head with on a daily basis. Basically, they're gonna do that by focusing on how horrible America is for slavery and how that's somehow Trump's fault, and they're calling it the 1619 Project. This slide into psychosis that we're seeing on both CNN and MSNBC seems to be related. For example, Stelter's refusal to refute the completely insane claims made by his guest. Apparently, comparing the current US president to the worst communist dictators in history is just fine, but watch the fuck out if you give Sarah Sanders or Sean You Can't Dice the Spice Spicer a job in the media.
That, I think, is why this does deserve outrage and backlash. Obviously, Sanders going to Fox is not surprising. There's been a revolving door between Fox and the Trump White House for several years.
First off, let me just point out how absurd it is that Stelter references the, quote, revolving door. People on the right and folks like me have been talking about the revolving door for decades now. But when we talk about the revolving door, we're talking about Democrats going into the media and then back into politics. Democrat politicians going into the media has been going on forever, and Stelter even admits it at one point, so I'm not sure why he's trying to manufacture outrage. This despite the fact all the Clinton and Obama former officials were all picked up by the Democrat media. People like George Stephanopoulos over at ABC, who is a former Clinton official, who famously attacked his accusers as bimbo eruptions. How about David Axelrod or former Obama press secretary Jay Carney? All of these people hired by the Democrat Party media. Are we really supposed to believe that these people weren't constantly lying? Or how about Jim Sciutto, who was an Obama political appointee on foreign affairs? He was hired by CNN. No conflicts of interest there. Come to think of it, didn't CNN just hire a disgraced liar and former deputy director of the FBI, Andrew McCabe?
Let there be no doubt that big, shiny, elegant, gold-plated opportunities, gorgeous opportunities await those who deceive the country on behalf of President Trump. It's Sarah Huckabee Sanders. Now, where can you go after lying repeatedly, daily, hourly? I don't know about hourly, but often.
So it appears that Cooper's never heard of a press secretary that wasn't 100% truthful. Strange, because I remember before Trump, and before Trump, it was always commonly accepted that politicians lie. Okay, now don't get me wrong, I'm not defending or excusing lies. I think that politicians should all be truthful, but let's be real here. Yes, press secretaries' job are to be spin doctors. That's what they do. Just to show you that it's nothing new that press secretaries spin the truth, here's an article from the Washington Post, a left-leaning publication, in 2014. The article is about Bill Clinton's press secretary, Mike McMurray, and describes the job as a hard-charging, super-political spin doctor. But you see, these people have to constantly rationalize their contradictions and double standards. All they're doing is redefining lies as spin in the cases of past press secretaries.
ABC has George Stephanopoulos, who was at the White House, of course, during the Clinton years. There's many examples of this. The difference, of course, is the Trump White House's record of misleading the public. All administrations spin. This administration lies consistently.
Again, like I said earlier, this is a tactic that they've been employing since day one of the Trump administration. Hyperbolically spinning common things as outside of the norm.
We've got an important question now. What does it mean to be a mainstream Republican? Candidate for governor, Ralph Abraham, is out with a new TV ad this week, making incendiary comments about gender.
As a doctor, I can assure you there are only two genders.
Making incendiary comments about gender.
Did she just say that an undeniable scientific fact is incendiary? What is it that we've heard from the Democrats and the left for the last decade? That the Republican Party is the party of anti-science, which I always found weird because I've always loved science. But now we find ourselves in a time where Democrats and left-wingers are claiming that there are an infinite amount of genders and that men can have periods too. They're even running headlines declaring that men are having babies, which we all know is a biological impossibility. The largest and most consistent body of scientific work shows that gender is a result of paternal hormones. While yes, there may be 1% of people who are born intersex, you don't just go and make up whole new genders based on a genetic defect. A defect that results in the expression of two genders, by the way. And those people who are intersex typically choose to be either one or the other gender. It's almost as if the Democrats only care about science and as far as it allows them to push their political agenda.
We have to collectively, in essence, burn down the Republican Party. We have to level them, because if there are survivors, if there are people who weathered this storm, they will do it again.
What the fuck?
You know how sometimes you can just look at somebody and know they're not right in the head? Well, take a look at Exhibit A. Clearly they've done some makeup work to hide a little bit of that crazy, but that subterfuge only lasts as long as she starts talking about burning down a political party and leaving no survivors. I often talk about how the Democrat Party and their media have two completely insane goals, one of them being eradication of all opposition, the other fantasizing about the death of their opposition. But in both cases, you see, it all leads to just them being in control with no dissent or opposition. This is another manifestation of that fantasy. And of course, no fake Democrat journalist would be complete without a heaping dose of hypocrisy, with Rubin's constant insistence that Trump's rhetoric is gonna lead to trouble. Of course, when she fantasizes about the eradication of her political opposition, it's completely different. No doubt this insanity is gonna ramp up the closer we get to the 2020 election, and I'll be right there to call him out on it. Please, please, please go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe, and you might as well hit that bell notification while you're at it. While my channel may have been remonetized, YouTube still demonetizes the vast majority of content that I upload. I still need your support, and if you would like to support this channel and help it to survive and grow, please consider subscribing to me on Patreon or Subscribestar. For just $1 a month, you get access to an exclusive video every week. Or if you just like to send me a donation, you can do so on PayPal. You can find all the links in the description or in the pinned comment. Thank you. We'll be right back.